Hello, this is Inspecting Immunology. Today, I want to talk about the symptoms of AIDS in women. This is a serious issue, so it is best if you have all the information. As a note, AIDS stands for Acquired Immune Deficiency Syndrome, and it is caused by HIV, or the human immunodeficiency virus. AIDS occurs because the CD4 T cells, which help fight infections, becomes depleted by the virus. So since it is related, I will be discussing the symptoms that are present from the beginning of the HIV viral infection. Let's get on with it. It is important to be aware of the early symptoms so that those affected can get treatment as soon as possible. Early in an infection, approximately 2 weeks after exposure, women can experience flu-like symptoms, such as having a headache, running a fever, and feeling run down. This is because the body has been exposed to a virus and is trying to fight it off. After a couple of weeks, the symptoms usually go away. This is one reason why HIV/AIDS can be difficult to diagnose early on. There may be changes in a woman's menstrual cycle. A woman with the infection may miss a period or experience heavier or lighter flow. Premenstrual symptoms such as bloating, weight gain, sleep disturbances, and appetite changes may be more severe in women infected with AIDS/HIV. These symptoms usually get worse over time. During any infection, people can experience swollen lymph nodes in their neck, armpits, and groin area. This is a normal response to an infection, as your cells are gathering there to produce more cells and antibodies that will fight off the infection. In women with HIV/AIDS, the lymph nodes may be swollen for several months. Another common symptom of AIDS/HIV is the development of a skin rash, which could occur at any region of the body. The rash does not normally itch, and it is red and flat. People may also develop sores. This occurs because the body is producing antibodies against the virus. The development of these symptoms alone do not indicate AIDS/HIV infection, but all the symptoms together, along with an HIV test, will lead to a diagnosis. Even if the skin problems that a woman is experiencing are not due to AIDS/HIV, those suffering with this affliction should still get it treated, as the sores and rashes could lead to an infection. Women with AIDS/HIV may also experience fever as the body is increasing its temperature in an attempt to gain an upper hand on the infection. If you're finding this information helpful, hit the like button or the thumbs up button so I will know to make more videos like this. As the infection goes on, women with AIDS/HIV will find that their immune system starts to become overwhelmed by the virus. There will be an increase in the amount of infections because the body cannot fight off all of it. Some of the infections include Salmonella infections from bacteria, Toxoplasmosis from a type of parasite, or pneumonia. And pneumonia can be caused by bacteria, viruses, and fungi. As a reminder, AIDS occurs because the CD4 T cells, which help fight infections, becomes depleted, and because the body is overwhelmed, other symptoms will come up, such as weight loss, nausea, shortness of breath, diarrhea, joint pain, muscle aches, and an increase or severe coughing. A lot of women suffer mental confusion as they just do not have the strength or the brain power that they normally would have if they were healthy. Women with this infection can develop immune-related cancers such as kaposi sarcoma, which develops from the areas around your blood and lymphatic vessels. Women with AIDS, HIV, can also develop non-Hodgkin lymphoma, which is a cancer that develops in lymphatic tissues and cervical cancer. Women with AIDS, HIV are more likely to develop breast cancer. Not all women may experience all or any of these symptoms. It is important to get tested for HIV/AIDS and discuss any issues that you are having with your doctor or your healthcare provider. Because there are so many women who are currently infected with the virus and do not even realize the havoc that is happening within their bodies, I encourage you to share this video with the women that you know. I have heard stories of women suffering from AIDS, and they did not know that they had had the virus for years. It's truly heartbreaking. As a woman, I'm glad that I made this video, and I truly hope it has benefit for other women. To learn more about what is going on in your body and what your immune system is doing if you have AIDS or HIV, I am wrapping up a video about this and will be putting the link in the description below, so you can check it out. I am also beginning to research a video about the next steps you can take after you are diagnosed with HIV/AIDS. Stay tuned for that video. I will also put a link to that video in the description as well. Subscribe and hit the bell icon so you will be notified when these videos are published. I want to make sure that everyone is well informed. If you have any questions, please put them down in the comments. Thank you.